and welcome to the first episode of Bike Destinations, a series about great places to enjoy mountain bike vacation. Today we are in Central Europe, deep in the forests of the Jeseníky Mountains and looking at the Riklabí Trails, one of the largest trail centres in the Czech Republic. This trail centre was established in 2009 as one of the first in the country and has grown a lot ever since. It has a great variety of trails and lots of other activities you can do here if you want to take a break from cycling. The base is located at the bottom of the hill and offers full service, including a parking lot, a campsite for those of you who want to stay for more than one day, which we definitely recommend, a restaurant with homemade meals and a variety of refreshments. An info centre where you can support this trail centre. Rent a bike and pay for camping. You can take a professional bike couch or send your little ones to a kids' school. You can find more information here. And the skills centre where you can train basic skills. And dirt jumps where you can join other riders on the sunset sessions. Now it is time to look at the trails. You start and end your ride at the base, and trails are marked with these wooden signs for easy orientation. Trails are divided into colours showing difficulty. Like in the rest of Europe, they range from blue, which is the easiest, followed by red, then black, to double black, which is the hardest. Green trails here are uphill. All trails are rideable in the wet condition because the stone here doesn't slip. For even easier orientation, we definitely recommend a very useful tool. Mappy.cz is a free app for your phone where you can see all detailed touristic paths, information, and also popular bike trails, including these at Riklabí Trails. You can also download offline maps for each country. If you are a complete beginner or ride with small kids, you should start with Blue Trails, heading north. These are very easy dirt paths in the forest without any obstacles and with not much elevation. They follow a river to a small city called Vindava. You can have lunch here in one of many restaurants. There are also a few flooded quarries and ponds nearby. In some of them you can swim. If you have some experience on the trails, you should be heading south to the hill Sokolovir, where the real party begins. This ride starts uphill, a few parts of it are on gravel roads, but most are a trail called Dr. Misna. On the way up, there is also the option to take fresh cold water next to the trail. When you reach the top, you have many options, depending on the difficulty of each trail. Superflow is the easiest on the hill, and it's a flow trail with rollers, berms, and other rollable features. Advanced riders can enjoy this trail at full speed, measuring about 8 kilometers without transfers between sections. It's a fun long trail. Let's advance a bit. Red Trails Tamjany and Mare Mujovi are old hunting paths built with small rocks. As they're almost flat, you have to pedal a bit. Down at the bottom of the hill are Hupsuk and Sjezdy. These two combine flowy parts with rocks and roots, with a few berms and optional jumps and ends at the bottom of the hill near the trailhead. Next on the list are Black Trails. They share a similar character, mainly built with stones. Proklity is a mix of flow and stones with a great viewpoint. Nauchnostezka, Volodbyr and Oblux are built with large stones. There are a few steeper and more technical parts. On the top of the hill is Wales, an old narrow stone path with a nice viewpoint in the middle. After Proklity, you can ride to Siestrab, which means hawk in the Czech language, which is arguably one of the best trails in Czechia. There is a combination of everything: rocks, flowy parts, north shores, technical parts, and loam in the end. It is not the longest or fastest trail. It is packed with features served in the right order and set in a beautiful landscape next to a small stream. Last but not least, there are double black trails. Tiris is a short trail with very steep rocks for experienced riders, and Velbud, which is longer but shares the same steep stone character. Some of the trails have chicken lines next to the hardest features, but the recommendation is to ride the easier trails first to get the feel for the stones, and then try harder trails if you don't have any problems. You should also look at the red crosses with numbers that are here to help locate you in case of an emergency. There is a lot to see off the bike. You can basically go in any direction and you will always come across some interesting places. There are reasonable prices for camping and meals. Since there are not any lifts or shuttles, the main source of income for trail building and maintenance are these voluntary fee bands, which are available in the info centre. One band for one person costs €5, and they are very important for keeping the whole centre going. Trails are usually open from the first weekend in April to the last day of October. If you enjoy being in the forest alone, we recommend avoiding July and August, because in these months Czech schools have holidays, so the place is a little more crowded. Also, there are usually less people during the weekdays than on weekends. The Czech Republic relies on a mild climate. In spring you can expect temperatures around 10 to 15 degrees Celsius with occasional rain. Summer is very sunny and quite hot, up to 30 degrees, but that can be ideal if you want to take a swim after a ride. Autumn is quite similar to spring, but the forest is really beautiful with colourful leaves. Do you want to enjoy your mountain bike holidays in the Czech Republic to the fullest? Use the advantage of full service trips from Czech MTB Holidays. This way you can visit multiple iconic trail centers and bike parks in one trip and have all the transfers, splendid holidays, and dedicated local guides simply covered. You can scan this QR code for more information. Ryklby Trails is a great place with fully equipped base. Its main mission is to build hard stone trails, but there is now a lot to do even for beginner riders. Set in beautiful landscapes, further from big cities, it's an ideal target for people who like being in nature with fresh air. That's all from this destination. We hope you like it. Stay tuned for more Shred reports.
Na co se ptáš, zlíč tu zhasíš.